My research, accompanied by my very capable nonsense alarm, will help all of you be prudent while dealing with customers, many of whom are naysayers about, why do I need a server refresh? We need to make more money for Dell and serve our customers in the best way possible, so all of you are going to be advocates to dispel these myths. Jumping right into how I created this research, what was the methodology? Dell EMC and IDC partnered with several companies with Fortune 500 credentials, 16,000 employees on average, $8 billion in revenues, close to 2,000 physical servers across various industries, as diverse as education or manufacturing. So this data is not biased at all. It's all encompassing. So you could be very comfortable in terms of, do I have the confidence to dispel the myths that are going to follow? What's the first myth? To get the most value from a server, use it as long as possible. Makes no sense at all. Because if you use a server over 6 years, you spend close to $150,000 adding up all the numbers from years 1 through 6. Whereas it has been observed that if you were to calculate 3-year cost of operations by refreshing servers, you get an operational cost benefit of 59%. You see that drop in terms of how much you would spend in your OPEX. And if a customer argues, in a 6-year cycle, what is that cost exactly that's going up? The biggest guilty party is the part in orange, which is the IT staff cost for management and support. So you've got to be able to convince the customer that that part will keep going up drastically. And that's why this "let's hold on for 6 years" is a myth. Going to number two, the cost to acquire and deploy a new server is more than just keeping the old one. That's what someone in the old ways of thinking is going to tell you. And you ring the nonsense alarm on them again. Why? Because we have not one, but 3 metrics to prove that they're wrong. Would you really be willing to live with twice the outages with a 6-year server cycle? Now, Mr. Customer, you know the costs and the revenues of your business better than we do, but I can safely guess that you don't want to live with those many outages. A 3-year server refresh cycle is going to reduce that number by more than half at a very conservative level. Meantime, to repair, you see 4.3 coming down to 3.6 hours per server. That's a significant saving in terms of server productivity. As you see, your number of lost hours per server are going to come down from 245 all the way down to 53. So why wouldn't you want to benefit from these metrics and instead assume that deploying a new server is just not worth it? That's your way to win over this myth. Going to the third myth, upgrading servers is a cash flow drain. Don't want to do it. Don't have the money. Nonsense alarm again. Because if you remember the myth one and compare that chart with this one, the average here comes out to 16,000 and change per server and overall 97,000, which is still 33% lower, as my little truth window says, compared to what you would get if you did not refresh. So do you want to let go of 33% savings? I'm sorry, Mr. Customer, where is the sense in that? And if you still want to deep dive, you want to double click into what are the cash savings that I will observe in years 4, 5, and 6, we're showing it right there. Yes, you will invest again in getting hardware, which is negative cash for you, but then you'll start seeing the positive cash flows that go up drastically in years 4, 5, and 6 that you would never otherwise see. So again, that's the way to help a customer with a cash flow discussion and dispelling myth number three. Coming to myth number four, we hear that often. Oh, it just takes too long to realize the benefits. Is it worth it? Nonsense, Mr. Customer. Really, all you need is 9 months. Here's our analysis. 5 months after deploying the server, the cumulative cash flow benefits that you're going to see is going to help you break even in 9 months. On a piece of hardware that, on a very aggressive end, has a shelf life of 3 years. So it's a clear business case. It's not as long as you think it is. So if this makes sense to you in terms of any number lower than 1 year, please, Mr. Customer, it's time for a refresh. That's how you beat myth number four. Coming to the fifth myth, new servers have no impact on revenue. All right, I'm not gonna ring this one very quickly here. Yes, Mr. Customer, we understand. Your business is not about appreciating our hardware. It's about helping your business make money. We get that. But at the same time, we look at ourselves as advisors. Here's how you're gonna make money. So, now's the time for a reality check. Servers are about managing workloads, serving more customers, and we observe that you can make, on average, more than $4.5 million by deploying an additional server, attributed per server, over $120,000 of revenue. 15% margin, over $18,000 that go into your bottom line. So, that's a business case for you. The last myth is about buying servers is a CapEx. No, Mr. Customer, we've moved to an OpEx model now. Take the example of a cloud services provider where we helped them buy 50 servers on a subscription model over time where there was zero delay in helping their end customers adopt technology. So use Dell Financial Services, pay as you grow, and be able to deploy technology today. And now that I've dispelled all six myths for you, go out there, go big, and win big.